Hi, Vassal.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
nice
you,
to
too.
Thank you for coming.
Beautiful house you have here.
Yeah, thank you. We just moved in not too long ago, and we're trying to enhance this side of the house curb appeal. A lot of foot traffic that comes around here. Mm-hmm. And a first step would be to put in some window boxes.
Well, we can definitely help you with that. I could build you three identical window boxes that really have a timeless look.
And I could fill them. They could have multi-seasonal interest. You could switch them out throughout the seasons. But what kind of sun do you get on the side of the house?
Well, this is the east-facing side, and the sun comes up that way. We get about 4 or 5 hours of direct light, I think, per day.
Okay, that's all I need to know to select my plants.
All right.
Well, if you're ready, let's get started.
I'm ready, let's go.
I'm gonna go to the nursery.
All right. So window boxes can be made out of a variety of materials. You can make them out of fir, cedar, but I really like working with PVC. It's rot resistant. You can even paint it later if you want to, and it'll age really well. I picked up some 1x10 PVC stock for the box, and to trim it out, some band molding and some base cap, and that's really all we need to get started.
Sounds great.
All right, let's set the saw up. We'll start cutting some lengths.
Let's do that.
For your window boxes, I'm gonna use the 1x10 at full height. I'm gonna miter all the corners, and I'm also going to miter all the trim with a 45 degree angle. I have some two-part PVC glue, which is really gonna create a strong bond. I'm gonna brad a little bit in the center. Now that we have that miter made up, I can use 2.5-inch long stainless trim head screws to connect the front, back, and sides of the boxes. All right, now we can add the bottom, and then we can do the trim around the top and the bottom. So for the trim, we have the band that's going to go across the top, and then we have the base cap that's going to get flipped over, and that'll go across the bottom. Set that in place. Then we have our return pieces cut, and then again that 1¾-inch rip, which is going to go on top of the cap. That'll really finish it off. And then we can put our returns on, and then we're all done. All right, nice. There they are. So the last thing that we have to do is just drill some weeping holes in the bottom. So I'm gonna use a 1/2-inch fade bit, and Jen recommended about every 6 to 8 inches. Nice.
All right,
we're ready to hang it up on the house now. So what I'm gonna do is actually permanently fasten this box to the home because of the size and weight of it. What's also nice is it's ground level. You can work on it here or from inside the house. So the way that we're gonna fasten it is into some studs on the inside. We know we have a stud package here and here on either side of the window. And then your clapboards are nailed 16 inches on center, so there should be a stud right behind there. So we're gonna use a 4-inch long structural screw. The easiest way to hang it up is to transfer a layout from here to the back of the box, pre-drill it, and then hang it up. So what we'll do is we'll come in here. If you want to hold my tape there, we're going to put one in at 11¼ and 27.
All right.
So what we'll do now is let's hold it up. Flush on your end?
Flush as flush can get.
All right. I transfer the marks of the holes to the clapboard. And I added caulking to each hole so it can seal around the screw as it penetrates. So now we're ready to hang it up. We're gonna do the screws. I have this special right angle attachment. We're driving them in. We'll hit the right and the left, and then I'll fill in the center.
Very cool. I haven't seen those before.
Guys, these look fantastic. They look so good without
they
even
do.
Any plants in.
Yeah, they came out
do,
good.
They do.
I'm done hanging them, so I'm gonna pack up my tools. I'll see you guys in a bit.
Okay, you wanna come check out the plants with me?
Yeah, let's go.
All right, let's do it. Okay, Vassal, the rain came just in time for us to do the planters.
All right.
So I just wanna show you what we have. I brought a combination of perennials and annuals, and let's just run through them. This is a maidenhair fern, and I chose it because it has really cool texture and I like the black stem.
It's beautiful.
This one is a Japanese painted fern, mm-hmm. and it just has that silvery color. It looks different in different lights, right, so that's really cool.
The greens are nicely complementing.
That's why I got them. Annuals. This one is a vinca.
And these die, right?
These, yeah. Annuals die every year. Perennials will come back. And then this one is a begonia.
Lovely pink.
Yeah, so that adds a little pop of color, especially in a shady area. So this is a annual called a bush daisy. And I really think it pulls the purples out of this, the stem of the Japanese painted fern.
And quite beautiful, the greens and the purples matching, very nice.
Yeah, and it's, there's no right or wrong. It's like whatever your taste or color of your house, and just put it together however you like.
Yeah.
And then for a trailing, this is an annual. This to trail off the side to cascade down. And I've got the variegated one because, again, pulling from the whites and the purples and
right,
the greens.
Right, right, right. It pulls it together even, like the white and, like you said, the green there.
Right. So I like to stage out a planter at first. It doesn't have to be exact, but I want to get the kind of layout. I like to put the taller things in the back. So these maidenhair ferns are going to go in back. And then originally, when I was at the nursery, I thought these would go in back. But now that I have it here, I want to put the Japanese painted ferns forward.
All right.
And then the vinca.
We'll put it right here.
Yeah, I like
all
that.
All right, maybe one over there.
Yep.
Preserve the symmetry.
That's what I'm talking about. Okay, and then let's add a little pink.
All right.
Looks good.
Oh, I love this.
Awesome, we'll do three.
And you're really packing them up, huh?
Yeah, you know, when we go to plant them, we'll like take off a lot of the soil so we can get them all in the box.
All right.
We need to add the purple. And then maybe, I think the purple next to the pink looks really good. And then we go for the trailers, meaning the ivy. Here, you take
all
that
right. one. On the edges?
Yeah, I think one on the edge, each edge, and then we could go
in the middle as well.
In the middle. And so, you know, it looks super full and packed right here, but all once right. you condense it,
looks beautiful.
Get rid of some of the soil, it's gonna really come together.
Awesome, thank you.
So let's take them over to the planter. I'll show you how we line it and get it started.
Let's do it.
All right, cool. Let's start with filling the first planter. What I wanna do is put landscape fabric down and to cover all the drainage holes so when you water it, it doesn't all just come out the bottom.
All right.
So hand me that piece.
Will do.
Yeah, and so I cut it to the length, so your 4-foot planter, it goes up the sides a little bit. Next, I'd like those bags of volcanic rock. I tried to get a lighter stone to help with the drainage and help with the aeration of the soil. All right, so I'm just spreading out this potting soil, and I specifically got potting soil, not topsoil. It's a lighter medium. There's, see the white specks, that's called perlite, and there's something called vermiculite in there, and it helps aerate the soil because you don't want a really heavy soil in the box. So next, I'm gonna need a brown bag because I'm gonna use it to tip extra bits of soil into. It's okay to take that much soil off. Here are the roots. So next, I'll just go back up, and I'm gonna dig a hole, tease the roots a little bit.
I see.
Mm-hmm. So this is a perennial, so at the end of the season, you could take it out and put it back in the ground somewhere in your garden, okay? Well, I have it about an inch below here, because when you water it, you don't want it to overflow. But just like you plant in the ground, you want the top of the base of the plant to be at the level of the soil.
All right.
Okay. How's it looking so far?
Looks beautiful.
Great, I do like that pop of white right there. Next, another purple.
All right.
It looks so good. It really dressed up this side of the house. Let's go clean up and find Nathan.
All right, yeah, he did a great job on these.
Yeah, let's we have to show him.
Wow, these flower boxes look so beautiful. Thank you, Nathan and Jen. Nathan, the boxes match the trim so well, and the flower arrangement just pops. Thank you so much, Jen. My wife is gonna love it as she comes home from work, and the neighbors will too, I'm sure.
They look beautiful.
They do.
So my tip for you is put this slow-release fertilizer on once every 3 months. It'll help vigorous growth.
All right.
And water.
All right, definitely water. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
And my tip for you is once a year, a little bit of water and vinegar on a rag, scrub them down, it'll keep them looking new.
All right, I will. Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
All right, thank you. Have a good day.
You're welcome. Take care.
Bye.
Thanks for watching. This Old House has got a video for just about every home improvement project, so be sure to check out the others. And if you like what you see, click on the subscribe button. Make sure that you get our newest videos right in your feed.